So I'd like to take my students onto a little journey to Stanford and show them our self-driving car that uses sensors to sense the environment. So let me dive into the class pretty much right now. So in our last class, we talked about localization. We had a robot that lived in an environment and that it could use its sensors to determine where in the environment it is. So here you can see the Google self-driving car using a roadmap, localizing itself. But in addition, what's shown here in red are measurements of other vehicles. The car uses lasers and radars to track other vehicles. And today we're going to talk about how to find other cars. The reason why we'd like to find other cars is because we wouldn't want to run into them. So we have to understand how to interpret sensor data to make assessments, not just where these other cars are, as in the localization case, but also how fast they're moving. So we can drive in a way that avoids collisions with them in the future. That's important not just for cars, it matters for pedestrians and for bicyclists. And understanding where other cars are and making prediction where they're going to move is absolutely essential for safe driving in the Google Car Project. So in this class, we'll talk about tracking. And the technique I'd like to teach you is called a Kalman filter. This is an insanely popular technique for estimating the state of a system. It's actually very similar to the probabilistic localization method we talked in the previous class, Monte Carlo localization. The primary differences are that Kalman filters estimate a continuous state, whereas in Monte Carlo localization, we were forced to chop the world into discrete places. And as a result, the Kalman filter happens to give us a unimodal distribution. And I'll tell you in a second what that means. Whereas Monte Carlo was fine with multimodal distributions. Both of these techniques are applicable to robot localization and tracking other vehicles. In fact, in a later class, we're going to learn about particle filters, which are yet another way to address the same problem. And indeed, they're actually continuous and multimodal. But for the time being, let's look into Kalman filters and ignore these other two families of methods. Let me start with an example. Consider the car down here. Let's assume it sees in this measurement an object here, 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 and here, where the time is t equals 0, t equals 1, 2, and 3. Where would you assume the object would be at t equals 4? Check one of those three boxes.